News this afternoon involving last week's fatal crash involving an Orange County deputy.
And we've now learned the deputy was traveling at twice the speed limit. West 2's Bob Keeling joins us live from Highway Patrol headquarters, where the first report on the death of a longtime lay minister has just been released. Bob?
Yeah, Jim, according to this FHP report, the deputy was going 80 miles an hour in a 40-mile-per-hour zone. It also mentions that the 91-year-old man who died in this crash failed to yield the right-of-way. It was still in the early morning darkness last Tuesday, just after 5:30 a.m., when the Highway Patrol says 91-year-old Edward Soistman pulled out onto Magnolia Homes Road. According to this newly released crash report, Orange County Deputy Melinda Miller was going 80 miles an hour in a 40-mile-an-hour zone and T-boned the driver's side of Soistman's car, leaving him fatally injured. At the time, sheriff's officials say, Miller was headed to assist another deputy in pulling over a burglary suspect, but Miller had not deployed emergency lights or sirens. So bottom line, this deputy was going twice over the legal speed limit. How much does that concern the FHP?
Well, we're doing our investigation, and we'll have to see. She is in performing her job. She is going to back up another deputy that is called for backup. So we just have to see if she's complied with state law required when she is responding to emergency.
And the FHP says this is the first of two reports. A more detailed investigation will be released in around 60 to 90 days. But the FHP also saying this deputy could be treated very much like any other civilian if the report comes down, the charges are warranted. Ultimately, she says charges would be up to the state attorney's office and what much more at 5. Reporting live from FHP headquarters, I'm Bob Keeling, West 2 News.